Welcome to the man cave. It's a calm before the storm. It's warm out right now, and I want to get a couple things done today while it's still warm. I got a package from Nikola Maletic, and I was complaining that on my racks here that I've got from KTM power parts. Boy, I'm tripping over my tongue today. That my Wolfman Rocky Mountain Saddlebags kept falling in between. I'll show you a couple pictures to explain what I'm talking about. And it was getting really close to the brake calipers. And if you look at my 2019, you see how I've got some space here, that there's some swing room between the swing arm and the bags. This is with a Vanasche rack with Wolfman bags. But when I had the same thing with the with the KTM or Touratech type racks, because they were sitting a little bit higher and I was trying to lower the saddlebags so I could swing my leg over the back, they would actually bend in and go in about this far, and it was really close. And Eric over at Wolfman, he even said that he was concerned that I'd be hitting the brake caliper. So this is what Nikola has suggested doing, and this is a product that he makes. One of many is that it actually is drilled so you can mount a gas canister on here. And I've had that just like on the back here, this rear rack. It's got the holes to mount the rack. I've kind of modified it with threaded holes because I like taking the bolts off without having to go underneath. But the same mounting pattern is on this. Okay, so this the strategy is fairly simple. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be attaching these cable clamps onto the rack like that, and then we're going to be mounting the plate. So inside the kit, on each side there are six cable clamps. I'll just dump on the ground here. Looks like it'll fit inside this, so maybe pair of pliers. I'm just gonna see if I can't stress this a little bit closer so it wants to just be there more naturally. Something to make a little bit more parallel like that. so I could put more force by putting my Allen wrench driver, and then I can hold it and push in at the same time till the bolt catches. Okay, that seemed to work. With it in this way, it's going to be slightly inset. If you were to do it the other way, it would be more, yeah, it looks like it's going to be right down the center of this line on either side. I like that. Let's just continue on. So I think I will pre-squeeze these guys. I've got this off, and you can relocate it. Like that, and it appears like that. Whichever way you think is stronger. I'm kind of thinking that vertical is best. Okay, so with the Rotopax mounted this way, it's resting on the rubber here. It's resting on the rubber there. And if this was slid up just a little bit, the plastic would rest on the rubber there. And same thing goes here. So I think that's an okay thing to do. Just slide these two up. So there you have it. With, because of the muffler and everything, this is a good side to mount your fuel on, because the muffler is over on this side. Okay, so I think the I'm going to continue on and doing the rest of this thing, and we'll see where it goes from here. Okay, I'm back to the other side. I'm going to pre-stress the stuff. I notice these things here are made in Germany. That's very refreshing. I get tired of seeing things made in China. Okay. So, now we got the side racks on. The left side was easier to put on than the right, just because it wasn't as tight right in here. I guess I can get rid of that guy. So, I don't know if I mentioned, in the first time I went to Baja, I bolted this on the back of my rack, and then this guy, I bolted on top of it. So, there was two of them up here. Now, this is a, let me show you the... This is an extension that you use in place of this handle, so you can double stack them. And if you guys watched any of my videos and saw me mount these things and you went and copied it for the Trans-America Trail, I'm really sorry, because within the first mile off-road, this bolt snapped off. So I had to strap this down with which is my water jug, just strap it down with a bunch of Wolfman universal straps, and then from then on I just left it in the chase truck. I didn't bother carrying it with me anymore. I just left the fuel tank on. So the other problem is that you don't want to put more than 15 pounds on the tail section by itself. At the time I didn't have a luggage rack, and I was using smaller bags because I had a big rolly that was on the back. But since then, I've gone to larger, like the Rocky Mountain bags, because I want everything to be down below so I can swing my leg over the back. So, but if you don't mind getting on the bike by standing on the peg and everything, you know, I would suggest, if you're going to carry two of these things, mount one on the side on the rack mount, and just mount your water up on the top, or your fuel, whichever one is the most convenient for you, and go from there. Also, one other thing, in Mexico, there was a couple of gas gap places that you had to go 200 miles, and my range was only maybe 180. On the 2019, it's got extra gas right there. So the gas, this is the... There's extra, see how thick the fender is right here? So you got an extra half gallon of gas that is not in the, on the 2015. So this time when I go down to Mexico, I'm not going to carry any extra fuel. I'm going to, trust my bike, except for I might have maybe just a single liter of gas in one of these little Wolfman accessory bags. So you guys decide that, whatever your risk level is. I'm learning how to travel light. It's taken me 4 years to do that, to get everything down where it's easier to carry with me and the dog and make it safer for both of us. So, I do have a question, though, I wanted to ask you guys, is... if I decide to sell this thing, do you think I should take off all the stickers? Strip it down? Buy new plastic? What do you think? Let me know. Mention that in the comments of how you think I ought to, if I wanted to unload my 2015 with, it's got 15,000 miles on it. If you can't get a decent price for them, it might be easier for me to just go ahead and strip this thing down to the point that it just becomes a standard 690 for trail riding. But again, I don't ride unless my dog rides. But we'll see how that goes. So, thanks for watching. This may be one of the last videos on the 2015, you see. So, think kindly and warmly of it.